What's going on, y'all? We're back for another episode of the Owner Operator series / the Company Driver. Still in Company Driver mode today. We're going to be hauling this EC-130 helicopter to, where are we going? Greenwood, South Carolina. So we're going from Knoxville to South Carolina. And then we actually have another helicopter we should be able to pick up after that. This stop really does not require us to take a break, so we'll run this one straight through. And she is loaded up and ready to go. Let's see, it looks like we're good on fuel. So we can go ahead and get right down to business. See, this job pays $548. Pretty decent. Given the mileage, it's almost $2 a mile. So this is a great haul for us. I think that was a stop sign. Far enough here for us to see. Alright, he's gonna let us go. Perfect. This video ought to be pretty decent, both money and XP wise, with two helicopter hulls that we're gonna do. See, the earliest we can drop this one off is 5:45, so we have plenty of time. We're just gonna set the cruise at 65 and let her roll. We should be fine in this lane. looks like we're gonna have to get off here. So go ahead and ask Garmin for a detour. See, it's gonna make us get off. Alright, we'll see if that'll work. See if it'll let us merge back. Okay, so we cannot re-enter from that direction. Go ahead and get another detour planned. So ask Garmin what we gotta do, because that ain't gonna work. Looks like that's gonna be our go-to, which is going to take us off-road, but actually, let's see what it's like if I go through Atlanta, because we really wouldn't take that road. I mean, we could, but it'd be a big pain. Ooh. Yeah, 9 hours. That was one hell of a detour. Man. That adds 4 hours to our trip. If I go that way, it adds 2. Yeah, I don't really see how we get out of this without going through Atlanta. So, looks like that's what we're gonna do. Do have enough fuel. But this drive definitely got lengthened. See, it says we're gonna be there at 9:30. Ooh, that's gonna be putting us close. That just leaves us 25 minutes. So we are going to be cutting this one extremely close. Could have took that way, but that's not something you would do in real life, so we're not gonna do that. Tell you what though, this detour might make or break us. Crossing the Little Tennessee River. And we're running into big problems. Once we get on the interstate, we'll be all right with time, as long as there's no more detours. But man, this is gonna cut it real close. Thank you. if there's an upside to any of this, it's that we're discovering new locations, but man, it's gonna make this haul a drag. Was a little tight getting through there. As of now, we are definitely late. Hoping that other helicopter job is still available by the time we get this dropped off. Thank you. miles. Made it to Georgia. So we'll just keep going south until we hit Atlanta, and we'll take the corridor east to get us pointed in the right direction. See, we'll go ahead and go to Garmin real quick. Maybe. Reset the nav. We should be cruising on Easy Street now. An hour. Okay, that sign was wrong. Here's the thing I don't know. If you have to extend your drive due to a detour, do you get an XP for the extra mileage that you incurred? I don't think so. Let's see, we need to take the bypass. Alright, so we've discovered Atlanta. Take the next exit that does not lead downtown. So we got about 3 hours on the interstate to go, and then we'll be there. It is going to be close. I mean, we're going to be within, I think, 10 minutes of making it. We'll be all right as long as we don't have to stop again. Go ahead and get our thumbnail here. I guess, good enough. These guys, so got some weather moving in. Mystic gear there. And this is going to slow us down even further. Great. Blows. This road opens to two lanes. It is not looking good. But you'll have that sometimes. Right now we are 20 minutes late. Or we will be 20 minutes late. Not good. Not expecting that. Alright, so we made it to Appalling. I do not think there is enough time for us to make up the time that we need. That is rough. And I think this will be our first late delivery. Here's the last 35 miles is off-road, and we can't do... I mean, I really don't even like 35 miles an hour down this road. This is really rough. Definitely not going to do 35. This thing is not going to do well. Officially late. surprised the speed limit is 35. I think 15 would be adequate here. Because it is a rough-ass road. Right, we got a delivery driver dropping boxes off in the middle of nowhere. That's not sketchy at all. I don't know if it strips money and money and XP or just some money. I think it strips both. See where they want this thing. So they got a 90 XP one. We'll roll with that. If we look, it's right back there. I feel like we can make that one probably pretty easy. We just need to go around this hill here. First try. So far, so good. Trailer over just a little bit. There we go. we'll get it this time. See if they take it. Yes, they will. Awesome. So we'll go ahead and pull it up just a hair. There we go. Green means they're happy, which means we're happy. We can get it paid. Maybe. So we drove 469 miles. We were late. Late penalty was not that bad. $69 and earned 166 XP. We'll take that. It's pretty fair. Let's see, look at quick jobs. And the other one's no longer here. Dang it. That's going to be a good paying gig, too. So we got this log loader we can pick up. I think I would like to do that. So go ahead and check it out while we're... Get the truck warmed up. We're in a Peterbilt this time. And it's a log loader. Let's see here. There we go. This is a pretty long load. We're actually going to back up to swing out of here. Let's see, where are we at on fuel? Gonna need fuel. So we'll look at we'll go ahead and get fuel before we hit the interstate. Let's see. We will need to rest as well. So we'll probably do that. We'll just pick a spot. I don't know what those are. Problem is, this is not your average size load. So, we're going to be kind of SOL on locations to park. I think that's going to have to be it. I don't see another one on 20. And that's a hotel, I believe, and we will not fit in there. So, go ahead and check everything out behind us. Again, we're going to have to back up, swing this turn out to go through there. Which should not be a problem. Let's see, go ahead and adjust our seat. Really, I think about... I think that'll be about perfect. These trailers do not like to turn. So we're gonna have to take this nice and slow. There we go, I think we'll make that. You guys can let me know in the comments too if the engine sound is loud enough. But yeah, we're ready to hit the road. This ought to be a lot better haul than the last one. What's going on here? Oh, that doubler is broke. We're gonna have to pass him because these guys are all in the way. I think we're gonna clear him. Oh yeah, we will. Close, but we will clear him. Perfect. Causes that to happen. I don't know if it's the AI mod or if it's a RAM issue with my computer. The map. So if I want to take if we go there. Ooh, buddy. 385 miles. And it says I could go 448. Yeah, we're gonna chance that. I don't have to roll in and out twice. So we could have took our rest up there, but that really that only gives us about a 2 hour buffer in case we were to have issues. our fuel mileage here. Definitely not going to get good fuel mileage. So with this load, we're going to capped at 55. Just because it is a big load and we're gonna have to save some fuel here. As we pass through Shreveport, Mississippi. That's also my get over, and we're gonna have to get back over. This guy's slowing down, but we're not gonna slow down to find out. Looked like a plumbing van. Left to go. right, it says we got 317 miles worth of fuel. Playing with going 55 miles an hour is we're keeping the engine at the beginning of the power band, so it's not at its most efficient point, but it's pretty close, but it's still able to go up some hills, overtake some cars, kind of do what it needs to do even at a slower pace, and still manage some fuel mileage savings. Some no stop. Passing over the Mississippi River. I'd say she's a beaut, but we can't see her. It's dark. Oh, what is that? Okay, just a random speed limit sign in the road. Wow. Okay. Luckily, no damage. I have to say that one's a little off. Ago. I think we're doing pretty good on fuel mileage and on time. On the truck. Do not want to have to pay for that. did forget to mention, there are two truck mods that I've left out because they are not up to date with the latest revision of ATS, and that is the, I want to say the FLB. Mac R. So both of those are Steam Workshop trucks. As soon as they show to be compatible again, I'll add them. The cab over we've drove before, the Mac R we have not. Let's go ahead and look. We got 155 miles, so let's ask Garmin where our rest stop is. Because we need to know. Okay, 75 miles, so yeah, we'll make it. Nothing to worry about there. Not going to break any speed records getting there, but we are going to get there and not run out of fuel. Alright, we're passing through Meridian, Alabama. As we head east. Guys trying to get into the way station. Could have done that earlier in my opinion, but it looks like we're still in Mississippi, not in Alabama. We're about to be in Alabama. Such as now. get over here. Station could not have come any sooner. We were just 48 miles to empty. I'm hoping these lodging spots are areas where we can just pull over. Swing this load out. Looks like we should be able to pull right in this gravel area. That is not part of the map. That was a little misleading. Okay, go ahead and shut her down here, and we'll be able to take our rest. So not sure what he's waiting on. Okay, we've got our sleep. Now we need to go ahead and get into the fuel station. This is going to be interesting. Shoot for the one on the inside, but I don't think I'll make that, so I'm hoping our load fits under here. It looks like it will, just barely. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and fill up. It should be a 300 gallon tank. Maybe a 250. Alright, so we got 213 gallons for $1,179. So, it's a 220-gallon tank. So we should be good now. Actually, I know we'll be good. Okay. Perfect. Do we have our lights on? Yeah, we do. Just want to make sure we do not want to get a ticket. So it'd be nice if that traffic would hold on for a minute. Awesome. Look at that. Tiny cars and big rigs coexisting. We're just gonna go ahead and make that light. Actually be there before the window opens, so that'll be fine. Got about 200 miles left and it'll be payday. This job pays $696, so we'll end up breaking $12,000 at the end of this video. I'd say we need about 30 before we start really being concerned about buying a truck. You guys can feel free to let me know in the comments, do you want to see every company driver haul that we do you guys like see like every other home? Because I understand these quick jobs can be kind of boring. It's kind of hard to put a story behind them. So if you guys would rather see less of these, I'm cool with that. Just let me know. If you're fine with the company driver portion, let me know as well. Anyway, so just 100 miles left now. There. Just about 30 miles left. Our exit is actually coming up, so thank you. Okay. This looks like us right here, but I'm gonna have to swing this turn. Go ahead and turn the high beams on. At least they got markers on this road, so you know where you're going. And this gravel road's only about 5 miles long. Last one we did was about 38 miles long. Markers are a nice touch. I give them credit. And we're here. We're about an hour and a half early. About 2 hours early, actually. Yeah, about 2 hours early. But I think they'll take it. We can ask this fella right here. Don't be looking at your watch like we're late. I'm here early, what do you want to do with it? Okay. He said park it. Figure out exactly where they want this thing. It's probably going to be like a just pull ahead and park it type deal. The diff. It's not budging. You gotta be kidding me. We're like stuck. Just center hung. The trailer is like digging into the ground. That is a first. Got us unstuck. That took a while, so I went ahead and edited that out. Alright, let's figure out where they want this so we can get paid in this video. Let's see here. 25 XP. We gotta kinda make a Yui right here. Okay. That would have been kinda nice to know before getting to this point. We'll see if we can make it work. I don't see why we shouldn't just gonna be driving through grass. Oh yeah. Yep, it'll make it. Cool. Green means they're happy, which means we're happy because we're getting paid. All right, we drove 565 miles. We got $696 and 1,507 XP, which means roughly, if we do one more haul that is somewhat similar, we'll be right on the money. If we look and see what's available, we got helicopters. Kind of hard to turn those down. See, that one's relatively short. That's only a 2.5 hour job. So that'll probably be our next one. And then we'll do the other one if it's still available. Even that log stacker's not bad. That would definitely get us there. But, here we go. Excuse me. That'll be it for this video. So just to recap, we got our first late shipment. We broke $12,000. So we're off to a good start. If you have not done it already, please go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. Looking at the used truck dealer, yeah, still the same. Not really sure what's going on with the used truck dealer. I am not seeing anything used. I mean, these are all like brand new trucks, so it's not something we're gonna worry about now, just because we don't have any money anyways. But around 30 grand, that's where I'm gonna be like, what's going on here? So all right, y'all, we are done. Stay safe out there. Keep it shiny side up. And I will catch you all on the flip side. See ya.